Hello students, in today's class we're going to learn what is meant by angles and what are its types. Now what we actually mean by angles is we come across angles in our everyday life. Now all around us we see angles. For example, when you look at the space between your fingers, now the space between the fingers, this here is an angle. So similarly, if you would like to draw it here, it looks something like this. Okay, now what is this exactly? It has a common point. If we name it as O, and this here let's name it as A, and this here let's name it as B. So what we have drawn here are two rays that have a common point O. Now it could be a ray or it also could be a line segment, but this is called as an angle. So this here is called as an angle. Now we see angles all around us. We can see angles in when we look at the English alphabets. For example, in the English alphabet A, the angle, we can find various angles. This here is an angle, this is an angle, and this also is an angle. But we can also categorize angles into different types. Now in order to categorize angles, let's look at a few more angles. Now for example, if we look at the English alphabet L, now this here is an angle. Now let's consider another alphabet, say the English alphabet H. Now let's consider this particular angle here, or this angle. Now there is a little, there is something different about this angle when we compare this with this angle that we have seen. So this angle here is what is called as a right angle. So this angle, because it is a right angle, we categorize the remaining angles based on this. So any angle could be less than a right angle or more than a right angle. So we could have an angle less than a right angle, or we could also have an angle that's more than a right angle. Now, if we look at this, this here is a right angle. We have already seen. So if you try to draw angles that are less than a right angle, it should be less than this. So here's an angle, example of an angle that's less than a right angle. Or this also here is less than a right angle. But what about an angle that's like this? So if this angle here is greater than a right angle. So these angles are smaller than right angles, and this angle is greater than a right angle. Similarly, if I look at this here, now this angle is greater than a right angle. So the names given to these are, if an angle is less than a right angle, we call them as acute angles. And if an angle is more than a right angle, they are called as obtuse angles. Now we also have a measure. A right angle measures 90 degrees. Now degree is a measurement of angle. You need to measure angle. So 90 degrees in short is written like this, 90, and we have a small dot over that. So this small circle represents degrees. Now that means if we come across an angle that is smaller than 90, like 30 or 35 or 45 degrees, that comes under the category of acute angles. And if we come across an angle that's bigger than 90, could be 95 degrees or 100 degrees. So that come under the category of obtuse angles. So in today's class, we've learned what are angles and what are the various types of angles.